Where am I? What's happening?
The graphics are good.
I'm trapped in a storm? How did I get here? And where is here? Wait, there's the lighthouse. I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there.
Nothing bad happened, sir. Oh, I was talking about the game, sorry. Oh my God.
Whoa. That was so surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I'm okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black
and white? I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream. Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless.
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
My dad's being cut up.
Oh.
And he was killed. And then he was put there.
Oh. October, my favorite month. Best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change color, turning into the tiny flames. But it's too damn hot, thanks global warming. And I can't bust out the big coats and sweaters or scary movies yet. Soon Kate let me borrow The October Country by Ray Bradbury. I haven't read much by him, which caused Warren to almost evoke my geek creator, I don't know, before I held up my copy of Battle Royale. But he knows the autumn atmosphere. Am I saying it right? Atmosphere. With small towns. The last time I wore a Halloween costume was with Chloe. I have pictures in one of my old albums. I should find a real Halloween party to crash so I can experience some social mingling. It's that or Vortex Club. Stroke Vesting Swimming Club. Swimming Party. Or is that Backstroke Fest? He's so punny, Max. At least I'm trying to climb out of my cocoon. I shouldn't expect my life to completely change after a few weeks of Blackwell Academy. As my parents love telling me on loop, you have all the time in the world. I got accepted into Blackwell Academy. Forts could dance, this would be a rave. Even though I've never been to one, but who cares, because I've got into Blackwell Academy. I didn't think I would be so excited, since it's not like I didn't used to live in the same town. But when I saw the text from Blackwell Scholarship Office, I could literally feel my pulse speed up. I thought I was going to say sorry, thanks for playing. It took me a few seconds before I read the whole thing. I guess I wanted to enjoy that last moment of blissom ignorance. And when I saw the first word, congratulations, I think I screamed. My mom cried and my dad laughed. They're so weird, but they're happy. And this means extra financial support, because they don't have to pay anything to Blackwell. This means new clothes, and if I can work it, a new laptop. Oh, and I have to keep telling myself in caps that I am going to Blackwell Academy. So this is it. I'm leaving Okay, I don't know. To go back to Arcadia Bay. Usually people go to the high school closets to home. I suppose I am too. It's just I haven't lived there for 5 years. Out of all the best photography programs in the world, I chose to go to the smallest back in town. In a town, I was excited about leaving. Maybe I wanted to come back all along, just to see if Chloe and I were still even friends. I do wish Chloe would have moved with us to Seto. I don't know. That city was made for her. When we would play pirates in our room and in the woods, it seemed like Seto was the faraway island of treasure and adventure that we were always seeking with coffee shops. But Satel wasn't very a fable. Ooh, country, I'm guessing. Country, I don't know. Now Blackwell Academy seems more exotic to me, more than any other place in the world to study photography under Mark Jefferson. Sigh. Insert heart and flowers. Plus, there will be cool, diverse students from everywhere. It won't be like my high school now. I never really found a groove with my classmates or boys. I'm lucky I have a couple great friends here, but it's time to ship out. So maybe Arcadia Bay will actually turn out to be the island for of treasure and adventure I've been looking for. Shit is crazy here. I didn't realize how much crap I had to pack until I had to pack all my crap. Mom and Dad are getting a little too excited. I'm clearing out my room, though I thought I caught my mom crying when she was packing my shirts. That made me want to cry like a little girl and never leave Seto. I don't know. So instead of packing, I feel like burning all my clothes, then just raiding a thrift store to build up a new max wardrobe over my junior year. Not that I even have an old max wardrobe. Nobody will know me except for Chloe, and who knows how different we are now. So I can cut my hair, get a tat, and some piercings. Maybe date a cute foreign exchange artisty from Paris or Rome. I can do anything unless I get busted. And there will be so many super cool chances of photograph to get exposed. Thinking about that is when I get scared but excited, and then I don't feel like crying at all. I get tingles down my arm, sensing the universe opening up for me. I can't wait to leave. I just want things to be different at Blackwell. September 2, 2013, at 12:07 a.m. My first entry for my new dorm room the night before my first day at Blackwell. Whew. I haven't had any time to write or even take pictures since I got here. My shit is in boxes all over the room, which is small, but mine. And I never want to leave. I can't wait to decorate. I plan a whole wall of photos. I did meet some of my dorm mates, though I suck at remembering names, so I won't bother now. But I think I can already see who's going to be cool to me and who's not. It's a bitch trying to get settled to a new school and social scene. After I found good friends in Settle. But I'm here now, and this is the start of my new life. Sweet dreams. September 3, 2013. Blackwell sucks ass. I haven't told myself not to whine so soon. But damn, the day started like Christmas morning. I barely had any dreams because I was so pumped. I start my first official day of my new life like a dork. Wait. Like a dork. I couldn't figure out what to wear, so I chose what was on the floor. I'm no good with names and faces right away, but I picked up some names like Kate, Brooke, Taylor, Alyssa. And how could I forget Victoria? Chase. Rich, stylish, and title. I could feel instant judgment when she looked at my raggedy ass clothes, as if I'm at Blackwell to strike fashion poses. Maybe I'm being extra crispy sensitive, but I think Victoria wants life to be like her own reality show. So that wasn't fun along with my... Oh god, I need to sneeze. With my general show unease, I thought it would be easier being back. Call the... ambulance, I'm guessing. Yeah, that. Call the ambulance. I don't want this date to end. Oh, whoa. Is Max... It was incredible to cross the green campus in the morning mist. I love the stone bricks and brick walls and brick walls of Blackwell. Everything is a picture waiting to be taken. Speaking of, at least one great thing did happen today. Mr. Jefferson's photography class. Sigh. There's more to tell, but journal, forgive me. I truly wiped out. September 4th. I have an assload of homework already, so much bullshit. At least give us news all day to acclimate. But to prove I'm not a total loser, I made a new friend in my science class. His name is Graham. And he's a serious geek, plus he's dark and witty. He comes across a kind of a know-it-all, but it turns out he does kind of know a lot. We talk about photographers, and he actually named a few I've never heard of. We traded numbers, and he'll be a good study partner, a good friend. I'll need at least one based on Q. I thought being 18 meant I didn't have to deal with this teenage drama anymore. I thought, at least I get to research famous photographers for some of my homework. Mr. Jefferson assigned us a ton of reading. This is exactly what I want to study. Jefferson is super cool and super chill. He doesn't try to be too hip, just says that what he thinks and expects us to do well. I think he's a genius. Oh my god, I want to... What the... Oh my god, I want to marry him. Just joking. This one class is worth all social dysfunction. Homework is kicking my ass. I bet the teacher's grades harder. Grade harder just to stop you from feeling special. But Victoria Chase and her snob minions still front like they honor their honored guests from Blackwell. The bros here aren't that different. A Nathan Prescott is Victoria's male clone with way more money and attitude. If that's possible, his family is the oldest in Arcata Bay. And I heard stories about them when I was a kid. The Prescotts give a load shed of bank to Blackwell, so Nathan asked like he literally owns the school. Yesterday during class, he put his feet on the desk, started texting, and the teacher didn't say jack. I'd get suspended, but him and Victoria are part of the silly elite vortex club that puts on popular parties, so they get their way. It's good to be the king and queen. I don't want to slam everybody. I do like Kate Marsh. She's down the hall and in one of my classes. She's so pretty and sweet and friendly. It makes her more beautiful than the beaches here, like Victoria. Here, like Victoria, who think beauty is just your face and outfit. See, I'm already playing their drama games. No more. Right, yeah, no more. September 23. Finally had a chance. Finally had a chance to take some actual shots around campus. On campus today, a perfect blue sky today. I always forget how great I feel. After I take pictures when I've been slacking off. Speaking of pictures, Mr. Jefferson told us about the National Everyday Hero photo contest he wants us to all to enter. The winner gets a trip to San Francisco, a lot of publicly. He wants just one photograph from each student. This is exactly why I wanted to come to Blackwell. To Blackwell. And of course, I'm scared shitless to enter. At least I have a couple weeks before the deadline in October, so I have plenty of time to stress and procrastinate. I don't know how to say that. Dang it. Inside. September 30th. I don't know whether I love it or hate it here. I'm trying to keep up with my science class of all things, like I give a shit or even understand it. Good thing I know Oren. Too bad I can't clone him to my place in class. To take place in my class. In class. Dang it, so good. Miss Grant is much cooler than the class. She explains particularly physics, so even boneheads like me can finally kind of understand. I love how she relates society to science and vice versa. I can tell she's committed and passionate about life, unlike some of us in her class. But I'm trying to engage more. Yeah, I did. Even if it means actually asking actual questions in class instead of hiding in the back. I'm just glad I'm not the only social misfit here. Now, how much homework are you avoiding? October 1, my favorite month, the best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change color, turning into tiny flames, but it's still too damn hot. Oh, wait, Okay. October 1, my favorite month is the best weather. The best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change color, turning into tiny flames, but still damn hot. Thanks, global warming. And I can't bust out the big coats and sweaters or scary movies yet. Wait, didn't I? Right quick. I just need to go back real quick. No. I feel like it made me... Okay. I see what happened. I did read this, but it made me go to page 8. Okay. I don't know if I want to read that again. Okay, well, and I don't feel like reading it right now. Okay, my name is Max Caulfield, and ever since I was a little kid, I knew I wanted to be a photographer. I've always been seeing the world through my own lens, Finder. Maybe it's a way for me to be part of the world, but at a safe distance, for some reason. I was always drawn to old and analog camera gear, rather than digital tech. I love all kinds of style and techniques, but for me, the instant camera selfie is the one I love most. I don't care if people make fun of me or not. I'm great company, right? And now I've come all the way to my voice. Okay, and now I've come all the way back to my old childhood home to study for photography, craft at Blackwell Academy, a private school for 12th grade seniors, on a scholarship even. I originally left behind Chloe, my best friend forever, at least until I left without talking to her once in 5 years. And it feels so weird to be back here without seeing her yet. So I'm 18 now, an official adult, even though I don't always feel so wise or mature. And I'm ready to begin a whole new life here with the retro camera at my side. Say cheese. Yeah. Okay. I've forgotten if... This is Kate. Okay. I've forgotten if I've ever seen Kate Marsh smile or laugh in the past month. She's really sweet and nice, and even though the other students make fun of her abstinence companion. I don't know. I'm gonna have to, okay, you know. Even if they act immature, everybody at Blackwell are seniors, not high school freshmen. She gets a lot of shit, in fact. I know she's involved in a lot of religious groups, but she doesn't preach to me, so I don't care. But she's been extra quiet and introverted the past couple of weeks. She looks like she's in zombie mode. I wish I could help her, but I barely help myself. I wonder if all that bullying has worn her down. I can see how it would. I have to make an effort to talk to her more often. Maybe invite her to tea or a movie. Although she's an adult, I bet she's not allowed to watch R-rated films. Sir Jefferson, the teacher. No, not only is Mark Jefferson one of the best photographers in the world, he's also my teacher, and one of the reasons I want to come to Blackwell. How often do you get to be mentored by one of your inspirations? I've always loved his deco and goth style, and he's so versatile. I can't say it. Okay. With all his incredible prints and advertising work. Still, Jefferson can be a bit condescending. He's pretty hip for his age, but kind of aloof, sometimes pretentious. He has a smug smile when he smirks. He's right. When he thinks he's right. But I do think he's preparing us for how tough it is to be a full-time artist. He acts like He understands my own work and obsession with analog images. He really wants me to enter a photo in this Everyday Heroes contest, but I've done a good job of avoiding that. The winner gets to fly to Francisco to represent Blackwell Academy and get national exposure. I'd like to think my work could be good enough to win and honored Jefferson even bugs me. And I'm honored Jefferson even bugs me about the contest. Victoria. Then there's Victoria Chase, the Elliot of Blackwell Academy. And a total bitch. I hate saying that. I don't know why somebody who's rich and beautiful needs to be a fucking mean. Be so fucking mean. 18-year-olds at a pretentious academy. Right. Prestige. I don't know. Academy. Should be involving into artists and scholars. Not reality show contestants. Victoria does everything for Maxim Trauma. She actually wastes her time calling me out in class and taunting Kate Marsh. For Rose, I wish her parents could see her in action. They cut off that trust fast. Then again, she's in the Vortex Club and they seem to own the school. So maybe that's why she doesn't give a shit. The odd thing is that she doesn't know art and photography. She can't even say all those French names that break my tongue. Her work is a little cold, but she has a good eye. She also has an eye for Mr. Jefferson, which is obvious that I'm embarrassed for her. She does everything but sit in his lap. He keeps his distance, though. We can all tell she's trying to win the Everyday Heroes contest. I'm sure it drives her crazy when there's somebody she can't buy or seduce. Okay, that is all. Yeah. And I'm guessing these are... Okay.
You saw humanity is tortured, right?
I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should.
Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though.
I do love my analog camera. I should take a quick picture now.
And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that... I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I did know, but I kind of forgot.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
Oh my god, she's a bitch.
The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century. But
portrait was done by Robert.
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson?
You can find out all
I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me. Yes, Victoria.
Victoria doesn't waste a second kissing ass.
You're submitting your photo for the competition. Everybody in class is turning in a photo.
Kate looks so sad and quiet today. Poor thing.
Hi, Kate. Oh. Hi, Max.
Kate, I hope I didn't embarrass you with my lame answer.
It sucks to be dragged into the spotlight.
Unless you're Victoria.
She's got nothing on you, Max. Well, I should get going.
Yeah, me too. Talk to you later.
Sure. Let's talk later, Max.
I only want to share whatever gifts I have in the world.
Even her school books are gift wrapped. I can't believe. Of course, Victoria has to have the bestest, newest, most. I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell. This is ridiculous. I always get so shy and nervous around Mr. Jefferson. Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. That's what separates the artist from the amateur.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
Welcome to the real world.
Just cute?
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture.
He plays it so sharp.
I need a serious time out in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
She's so fucking shy.
Alyssa is always texting, but she doesn't hang out with a lot of people. Evan doesn't say much to me, but his photos are very cool. I hate having everybody see inside my locker. I love that picture of Mom and Dad. Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. Andy, you look totally fabulous, as usual. Be part of the world around you. Driving a car. That's by the Dana seaside, talking to, I think his name is Justin. Dana is on my floor too. She's such an archetypal, gorgeous cheerleader. They must make them in a factory. Stella is always deep in her nose.
She my first one, go see who are these around. People.
To all of you, American. There's Taylor, always waiting for Victoria. I think that's Courtney. She's such a slave to Taylor and Victoria. American girls like dollies, with shiny smiles and plastic buddies. I wish I had. These missing persons posters are popping up everywhere. I shouldn't be so stingy with my blood. These missing persons posters are popping up everywhere.
I cry sometimes, walking around my own place, wondering.
I've seen Brooke hanging out with Juan. She seems like his type.
Talking about her own place.
Poor Daniel, he's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan.
How do I get to this guy name?
Poor Daniel, he's so nice.
Oh.
I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan. I hate bully jockstraps like Logan. And he's a Vortex Club member. They should just call it a sugar machine. That would be awesome if you put money in there and a bag of sugar dropped out. Good thing I left my AK at home.
Is she all just over?
What actually happened to her?
She's just all over? Holy... Okay.
That's so messed up. I should contact them to find out what I can do. As if I am.
Let's see what else they got here.
Don't need a PC. Missed the Poetry Jam tryouts, and I did not steal that backpack. There's Hayden, another Vortex Club bro, but he's actually not an ass.
I think she is.
Oh, I can hardly wait to never be too cool like Nathan and Victoria. Lame.
To all of you, American girls, it's sad to.
She's missing everywhere. Holy shit, that's crazy.
American girls,
nobody can see my meltdown, except for me. Now, who would bother to write that crap? Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it. When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day. Where did that butterfly come from? It doesn't look like any kind I've ever seen before. The blue wings are practically glowing. I can almost feel the air moving around me. The butterfly feels almost like a spirit.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho! No! Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
These pieces of time can frame us.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow.
Oh, I see what this is.
Now Kate is being hassled again.
Oh my god.
And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit.
Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Captured the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy, I might as well go all the way. Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
I did it.
Can you give
I
me
actually
a
did
of
it.
A photographer who perfectly captured
I'm a human
the
human time machine.
Anybody? Bueller?
Wowzer, my old broken camera is
there
new
you
again.
Go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of
when
her
I took my selfie,
space.
Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
course,
this.
You all know, the
it's real.
Has been
I can tell.
Whoa. That's, I love this
so
already.
I can go back in time.
Selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet? Can I save her?
Portraiture has always been a vital aspect
holy
of art.
Crap, she's like, yeah, she's like the time machine. She goes back.
Check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows
Jefferson wants to keep me
who
after class.
Girl,
and I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again and give him the right answer?
Yeah, exactly. Why does it do that, though?
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually
Wowzer,
finish.
My old broken camera is new again.
Okay, we have to hurry up. Come on.
And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest.
Oh my
I'll
god.
Out with the winner San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world.
Okay.
It's great exposure, and it can
first, I
want to
check on Kate because I don't.
Stella,
yeah, I know the girl's gonna together. Probably get shot,
Taylor,
but.
Don't hide. Still waiting for your
I need
yes, Max,
to check on her.
See you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Nice answer, Max. Are you okay? You look pale.
Kate, did we talk at all today?
This is the first time. What's wrong?
I'm sorry, I'm just dripping. Too much stress.
I know the feeling.
I wish we didn't. I do have to go, but we can talk later if you want.
I'll see how I feel. Thanks, Max.
Okay, good. Okay, good. We gotta move. Who cares about these two people? Because I don't care. He has nothing important to say. I don't care.
I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry.
Okay. Okay. Oh, yeah. He needed it.
I'd never let one of photography's future...
I'm not avoiding, just...
biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what...
Okay, come on, hurry up. We need to go. Hurry up.
Go on.
Please.
Don't let me stop you.
Yeah, please. Thank you. Wait. Okay.
This process, but I also want everybody to know that this photographic world is not...
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you?
Can I, please?
Yes. Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's...
Please, I just...
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers. Good. Make sure you finish working on it by today.
Please, hurry up. I don't want to let that girl die. Please, I want to run. I want to run there and, like, actually go get her, because I don't...
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom.
Okay.
Please.
Just skip all these people.
I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy. Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am!
Come on!
Who you're messing around with!
Where did you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
No, he has a gun! I should do something else.
To control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this.
I need a hammer to break it open.
Would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Oh. Holy shit, I can't let this happen. If I can reverse time again, I can help her. I have to rewind now.
Oh my god, I can't believe that just happened.
Tell me what to do. I'm so sick of people trying to control me.
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
No way.
Don't ever touch me again, freak.
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone, and please turn off that alarm, since that's your job.
Dang, he's so rude, though.
Hold on, Max. Come back here. You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You could always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
class.
Just
tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside with class. Please.
That's rude. That is so rude.
No,
you can't.
He does not buy that at all. I may have just...
That is just rude, straight up. Wow. That is just straight up rude. Wow. Okay. Okay.
There's Caden in his Vortex Club harem. He sure is living the dream. Hey, Hayden.
There she is, the retro selfie master.
That's me, all right. You look relaxed as usual, Hayden.
It's a skill one cultivates at Blackwell.
I'm gonna try to be more social.
One represents the Vortex Club. Not to boast.
What the hell is the Vortex Club anyway? It seems so elitist.
Only if you're not cool enough to get in. And it doesn't hurt your resume.
If you say so.
I do. But you should actually come hang with us one night. Then you wouldn't be so inclined to gossip.
You mean hang with a Vortex Club? That sounds like a setup to a horrible prank.
Chillax, paranoia girl. We're not that desperate for fun. We know how to do that on our own.
It seems weird to think about partying with all those Rachel Amber posters up.
You're high. Rachel used to hang out with us too. She was a blast. Smart, not bitchy like, you know.
Let's talk later, Hayden.
Bye, Max. No, I have to get my chemical on and study. We should get you and Dana out one night.
Brooke.
Brooke actually has a drone? Hi, Brooke.
Let me guess. You want to fly my drone?
Is that really yours? Is that even legal?
Of course. Nobody knows about it yet.
Isn't it considered a weapon of war?
You read too many conspiracy sites. This might be too complicated for you. Funny. Warren said you were smart. Please, step back. Sorry, Max. I have to focus on making sure this drone doesn't crash.
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
Where's the dorm? Sorry, but like...
Hey there, Stella. Hey, I know you. You're the new quiet girl in Jefferson's class. Isn't he incredible?
I think so. We're lucky to have such a famous teacher. And I actually love his work.
Me too. His New York urban stuff is great, but I'm glad he came back to his Oregon roots. Screw the East Coast elite. It must piss off those pretentious galleries that Mark Jefferson is teaching photography to us Blackwell Hicks. Plus, he is pretty hot for an older guy. If Victoria wasn't all over him, I would definitely make a move.
Victoria is pretty obvious. I don't think Jefferson is into her.
I don't think she's closed the deal, but she's not the only player.
Now, how do you know this?
You have a lot to learn here at Blackwell. Rachel Amber absolutely had sex with him. Well, I heard that from a good source.
So, you knew Rachel?
Not really. I saw her hanging with the other cool kids like Victoria. Not my kind of clique. But I heard insane stories about Rachel.
Who's Rachel again? I feel like an
That's
idiot.
So cool that Blackwell is doing a show of Mr. Jefferson's work.
Justin.
Yo, Justin.
Check out the Max. Come to Thrash?
Thrash? You mean stage diving, or...
You're such a poser. If you can't even name a simple nose slide or a tray flip, you should walk on.
Damn.
We're done talking. You're too sketchy.
Damn. Okay. I could have picked... Yeah, but right now I have somewhere to go, so I don't really have time. I'm guessing the dorms are that way. I don't know, honestly, anymore. Who is that? I don't know. Wait. Oh, he likes to photograph too.
Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous falling soldier?
I don't know which one to pick. I would.
Isn't it Robert Dornau?
Oh my. You can't even tell the difference between street photography and
Dang it.
No portfolio peek for you.
Please, I want to go back. Yeah, I just... Right there.
I think his name is Evan. Hey, Evan. Mind?
Let's see if you're worthy of it.
Steve McCurry?
Unless he could travel back in time. McCurry was born 5 years after the falling soldier picture. McCurry also shoots in color. In other words, no portfolio.
Dang it. I really want to do it. Sorry. But, like, I gotta.
I think his name is Evan. Hey, Evan. Mind if I...
We got this. I think it's... Robert.
Robert Capa, of course. I love his work, despite the controversy about that photo.
My, my. This quiet child knows things.
That's why I'm here.
You're a kindred spirit, Max. Would you care for a perusal of my portfolio? It's not a privilege I grant to many.
I'd be honored, sir. These photos are great. And Rachel Amber's face is mesmerizing.
Okay, we need to go to the dorm, though. Mmm, like, dorm. So. Oh, we have to, like. Alright, let's see.
Come on, Logan, bring it, Brock. Yeah.
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
Okay, we don't have time to look at things then. I don't know where the dorm rooms are. What's your...
Oh, look. It's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled.
Damn, she's such a bitch, dude.
Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way. That's the first and last time I expect to hear that.
Yeah, we're gonna get her out of the way. I don't care. Yeah, no. We're gonna have to... Ooh, here it is.
I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell out of the way.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
Okay. Maybe if I talk to one of these guys, they might just like... No. Come on. Perfect. Here we go. Look, we can go in here. She knocks out too bad.
This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use.
What am I supposed to do? A butterfly. So, how do I take my camera out?
Damn, I missed something. I better rewind.
I don't know where the fuck I'm supposed to go. Okay, hold up. We need some more thing.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Who is this girl, anyways? We're gonna watch her from afar. Bro, how do you take pictures, though?
Close, but no cigar. They have to be right under the bucket.
What the hell?
Okay. None shall pass. Capiche?
I'm gonna have to start over. Don't talk to them at all.
Understand English? Get lost.
That's the first and last time I expect to hear that. That's all you can do. Stop before you hurt yourself. Okay, let's see if this works.
None shall pass. Do you understand
Victoria
English?
Is not getting
get
the hint.
I don't know what I'm supposed to do.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
Yeah. Sorry, no paparazzi
allowed. Victoria is not getting the hint.
Nice.
Close, but no cigar. They have to be right under the bucket. There's only one way around this.
I don't know what to do. Why is it not working? Okay. Alright. Okay. I just need to figure out. Okay. Yeah. Hello. Hi. I'm streaming right now. Yeah, don't worry. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this.
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
Yeah.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Okay, here we are. And they might actually hear ya, I think. Unless I have it not on the party. You know what would have been cool? Alright, this right quick. I wanna do it right when he gets there. Cause I don't think I missed up the bucket either to actually think about it. Alright, quick. Okay, I don't wanna do any harm to myself. Jumper this. So when he picks it up. And then we're gonna
let's see if this works.
Wait for him to go over there. Hello? Wait. Is it even working? Wait. The heck?
This flame sprinkler valve.
Dang it.
Is easy enough to use.
I messed up. Okay, right here.
Close.
Dang it.
Cigar. They have to be right under the bucket.
Right here. It's called Life is Strange. Look right here. Right here. Look. What's just gonna happen?
Water on my cashmere? Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Awesome.
Right now, look. He's about to. Yeah, I know. Right. Look. Look right here. Right here.
Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo.
That's what she gets, though. She wasn't, the reasoning why I did that to her, because she wasn't moving away from the dorm thing.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
Yeah, no, I'm going to. Oh, I was about to go back in time.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I'm gonna be nice to that then.
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max.
We're just gonna. We did it because she was rude.
Hope the sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on
me. No, she said it. She said, hope those sluts. Okay.
You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck yourselfie.
Yeah.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
There you go. She moved, and we're nice, but it's just so... Probably played me. It's just because... what's it called? So she can move out the way, but we're still going to be nice so we can have, like, a good relationship with her, you know what I mean? But we only did because she wasn't moving. She was, like, being, like, really rude. So, like, do they show... Damn.
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long.
How am I supposed to know where my dorm is? Oh, right here.
Home sweet home. Favorite cocoon.
I should be going, getting ready, but I just wanna finish this real quick. What did I play some music?
Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be.
What time is it?
Idiot.
What, I need to get Warren, right? That's how you say his name.
Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
Dang it. Where's Dana's room?
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell. Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria did.
I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth.
Victoria is outside.
No need to go there now.
No, we don't need to go to the showers. Not the...
At least that's an alarm from this century.
They had left the door open, holy shit.
I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
How do I... How do I print this? Okay, never mind.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Please don't want to enter. That's the last thing I could ever want. And we're just nicer too. That's kind of sad.
Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Flash drive right there.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
I don't feel like, you know, no.
She has everything. And
oh, yeah, and Victoria, I think, if I'm correct, it's the girl that had paint with her.
I'm in it, and Victoria creeps me out.
I think.
Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
If I'm correct, it's that girl. I forgot.
What do you mean?
Oh, nothing. When you opened the flash drive, didn't you see the special folder called Max?
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
He did? I need to see this. Run. Okay, we're gonna go back and I want to see this. Did he really? I guess she wasn't looking at like her thing. Okay, well, that's fine then. Okay. Oh, wait, wrong way. Flash drive.
I better make sure everything is still in there. I think Warren forgot to hide the Party Buster folder. Not that I would open it, no matter how tempting. I have my self-respect. I am so addicted to this site.
Hey, what the hell?
Beauties. Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here.
She's a little too obsessed with the camera. Okay, we gotta go. Where's Warren, though? Okay. Parking lot now. We have to go. Parking lot. Where?
Oh! That hurt!
Damn. Ouch. Poor Alyssa. That'll leave a bruise. Ouch. Poor Alyssa. That'll leave a bruise.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
Fuck.
I could almost feel sorry for him if he wasn't such a serious dick.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not doing any interviews.
I might let her check on her if she's okay. No. Okay. Wait. Can I throw the thing back at him? No, I'm not. Okay, somebody who texted that thing. I would throw it back at him, but I can't. Okay. Well, parking lot we go, because, yeah.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront. So you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone.
Now I took a picture of that. I'm probably gonna send it to the... Yeah.
Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Max.
Now I feel bad. I wanna go back now. I'm gonna go back. I don't care.
I should have stepped in between Kate and David.
That asshole was so over the line.
I'm going to right now. I'm just gonna do this real quick.
If you do this again, because your ass needs to be getting ready.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell.
I am.
Understand what I'm saying?
No,
I'm gonna get off right now.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official.
Okay, well, I'm gonna have to get off of this. Yeah.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody.
Okay.
Doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Okay.
Oh, Max, that was great.
Okay.
I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a
this
lot.
Way.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate.
It's not working. I don't know why that's not working. Okay. It's not working. This is making me really sad. Okay.
Can't stand to see people being bullied.
Yo, Max, check it out. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the
Probably likes
time.
Her.
But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended now.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
My books.
Yeah, thanks. You have some cool shit on there. From Akira to Twilight Zone? Which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
How so?
Sensitive usually means won't be having sex with you.
Oh god. You need a sensitive woman to kick your ass.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should crew down in my car to an actual movie this week. You seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Next, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw. Answer
me,
bitch. I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me. I pay people for that. Or worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
I could call the police.
Do it! The Prescotts own the pigs here.
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal, or that whore
Wait,
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Lauren! Oh, bro, I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up. And dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Where are my shoes?
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
But you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it at my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
Okay. I think that's all I need.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Guess I'm gonna leave at like 8:30. Yeah. It's not too late anyways, school's near. It won't take long enough.
looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly...
All right, quick. I'll be back. Okay, I'm back.
Here, make sure. Close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Ow. Where's her music thing? Where's your music
thing? When's the last time I had to dig through Chloe's crap? She looks super happy. She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
Why am I searching?
Who would have thought Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown up?
Not much. You know me. I like to observe the world more than participate.
I can't say I know you anymore. Maybe you love to go clubbing every night.
Can you see me at a rave?
I'd dose those candy flipping morons and twitch into a DJ Chan's death rattle. Take a photo of that. Hey, did you find the disc yet?
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close. I think this chunk swallowed her discs.
Okay, I might have to leave right now. Real quick, I just try to...
...to dare each other to climb down, but never did.
Quick.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch.
Rachel. Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
What about your mom? What did Joyce think about all this?
She couldn't wait to get rehitched. Step dick is one reason I wanted to bail.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
What about her parents? Are they looking for her?
They're in denial. Max, I know she's missing.
I assume you know more than that.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Down.
And it reeks like dirty laundry. Gross.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thanks.
Damn, Chloe was kicked out of Blackwell 2 years ago. She used to be a great student. When she cared. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
She looks super happy.
She looks super sad.
She looks super stoned.
How am I supposed to put the music on?
Is this a desk or a storage space?
Go on, it's an MP3, not a vinyl. You can play it.
This postcard is from Rachel Ember. We had such a blast drawing these together.
Where's her thing? That's what I'm... Oh, okay. I see.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment. Can you let me chillax for a bit? Alone? The tools are still downstairs.
Downstairs, and I'm pretty sure the garage is...
Doesn't look like the Price family is rolling in dough these days. Nope. Someone locked it from the other side. Seen this place in 5. Joyce still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia. I better get one soon. I should be able to find the tools I need here. These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that.
Tiny tools, tiny tools, tiny tools. Tiny tools.
Yes, score. Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've got to be shitting me.
Ugh.
Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Nothing. This is so lame. Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead. Cool, now it's open. Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years. No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals? This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this? Should I switch this on? Decisions, decisions. These are way too big.
I don't know what to do. I don't know where. I'm gonna close this cabin to make an eye, I suppose.
Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Let's see. The tools are stuck. Man, I should have done that before they fell. Let's
you
see.
Ready to go?
The tools are stuck, out of reach, and no way in hell to get
okay.
Them. Brilliant, Max. Brilliant.
Okay, Mom. Mom. Hello?